एकम
यदा
भगवान् राजन्
अभिषिक्तो द्विजातिभिः
अभिषिक्तो द्विजातिभिः.
So one point, what is that kind of civilization that sings their highest instructions? What a peaceful society that must be. Any scientist, any educational institute today sings their knowledge to their students? Why not? But why it is there in the Vedic culture? Why they sing it? You think that one point. They sing it, it is meter, it's a rhythm, it's a song. But it is knowledge. How you can just sing knowledge? Huh? You know, in chemistry you're singing your chemicals? Huh? No, it's just hardcore tactic. So just we have to understand how brilliant this culture must be. If you do things right, you're happy. If you don't do things right, you're not happy. So
Sri Narada Vacha.
Sri Narada Vacha.
Narada Muni said.
Narada Muni said.
Parada.
Parada.
Parada Maharaj.
Parada Maharaj.
Api.
Api.
Also. Tata.
Tata.
In that way.
In that way.
Chakre.
Chakre.
Executor.
Executor.
Pitu.
Pitu.
Of his father.
Of his father.
Yat.
Yat.
Whatever.
Whatever.
Samparayikam.
Samparayikam.
Ritualistic ceremonies performed after death.
Ritualistic ceremonies performed after death.
Yata.
Yata.
Even as.
Even as.
Aha.
Aha.
Order.
Order.
Bhagavan.
Bhagavan.
The Supreme Personality of Godhead.
The Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Rajan.
Rajan.
O King Yudhishthira.
O King Yudhishthira.
Abhishiktaha.
Abhishiktaha.
He was enthroned in the kingdom.
He was enthroned in the kingdom.
Dvijatibhihi.
Dvijatibhihi.
By the Brahma's presence.
By the Brahma's presence.
Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila.
Yeah, yeah.
Sri Narada Muni continued.
Sri Narada Muni continued.
Yes. Thus, as the Supreme Personality of God ordered, Maharaj performed the ritualistic ceremonies for his father.
Yeah.
O King Yudhishthira, he was then enthroned in the kingdom of Hiranyakashipu as director by the Brahmanas. Purport. It is essential. You take this carefully. It is essential that society be divided into four groups of men: Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Sudras. Here we see that although Prahlad was perfect in every respect, he nonetheless followed the instructions of the Brahmanas who performed the Vedic rituals. Therefore, in society there must be a very intelligent class of leaders who are well versed in the Vedic knowledge so that they can guide the entire populace to follow the Vedic principles and thus gradually become most perfect and eligible to return home back to Godhead. Om again, Timanadasya, Timanadasya, Sakya, Chakram, Tamina, Tasmai Sri Vedha, Snigdha Chaitra, Prahata, Prabhupada. Yeah, so here Narada Muni is explaining the pastime of Nrisimhadev and Prahlada Maharaj to Yudhishthira Maharaj. It's amazing that Big political leaders are discussing these high devotional topics, right? That it means, it looks like that is the way to manage anything. That's the first principle. Unless you have pure-hearted, whatever system you want to put up, it will not really work. Makes sense, right? And that's why these political leaders, they were always attentive to hear this knowledge from very elevated, pure hearted, saintly people. Then you will see the next chapters, what comes behind this, after telling the story of Prahlad. The 30 qualities every single human being should possess. And again, it's quite interesting, then we will have this chapter on the necessity of Ranashram. And I want to touch again a little bit in connection with the verse today, and what we will follow in the next chapters will become very interesting, because it's very much related to Ranashram development, which is now the hottest topic in our moment. And if you don't go that way, you cannot survive. So here, an interesting point comes. So, Vlad Maharaj has asked Nrsingadev to forgive his father and to you know, bless him, that he can make progress. And
that's a good school for that. So.
Prepare for it.
Yes.
It's amazing that in the previous verses also said, no, although Hiranyakashipu has behaved so horrible, not exhibiting any devotional quality, but he said, after all this, still, it is said in one of the verses, that Prahlad, because Hiranyakashipu was his father, he never lost his feeling of affection for his father. Such a horrible personality Hiranyakashipu exhibits himself. And up to the point, torturing his own son, but the son never gave up that affectionate attitude. You can imagine this, it's very difficult. It's very difficult. We sometimes even not yet have to come to point to have an affection for devotees, or to speak like an attitude to people who are not devotees. So this is a very, very high culture. This is an extremely, it's very difficult to understand that consciousness. We are just entering into that world. We are just entering into the concepts of devotion service. And we are just entering into the technical application of sadhana bhakti, which is an imitating process of the real thing, sadhana bhakti, which is absolutely required, but it's not the real thing. It is even said, only sadhana, if you follow, you will never ever get the real thing. You have to add something. But without sadhana, you will also never make your progress. So we are just getting glimpses, we get theoretical understanding, what is real, pure devotional service, what is the attitude of the devotee. We cannot find it anywhere. Very difficult. We are too much in the brain, too much technically understanding it, but that has nothing to do with the reality. Philosophical understanding. Intellectual understanding. That is just a baby work. The real thing is absolutely living in that consciousness, that pure devotional consciousness. And the essence of that is great affection. You can see in Krishna how much affection he has. The pastime Dandarastikam, every day he's singing. Yeah, you go through the text. Verse 1, verse 2, verse 3, he builds up your love for Krishna. this text of Dhammavastakam is such a perfect psychology for all devotees. First he describes the body of Krishna as a baby. And then he said, then describes Mother Yasoda. She's not binding with ropes, she's binding with love. Then it describes, you know, that all the inhabitants are drawn into Krishna. They are doing so many other things, but that is not important. But the main thing is Krishna. But we do so many other things which we think is more important. And when it comes to Krishna and Krishna's devotees, it is all secondary almost. A little bit black and white. It's all about the practical performances, not about the person. So always we remember Krishna and his devotees are inseparable. You cannot have a different mentality towards Krishna and the devotees, then you become Kanishtha Adhikari on the spot. And Kanishtha Adhikari is always full of trouble. It's imitation work. If you don't see the devotees as they are, and if you feel great love and affection and humility to them, and respect and bowing down at any second to such a devotee, then you cannot understand much. Although you might have a sharp brain, technically, but spiritual brain is very slow. It will not be given to you. You cannot see it. Krishna will not give you the eyes to see, give you the mentality to do. And that's why we cannot develop big obligation. Always remains, you know, few years somebody coming and somebody going, somebody coming, somebody going. But you see, some places there is a huge congregation. In the Middle East, they develop 5,000 members and they are like this together. And they have quarrels, they have sometimes misunderstanding, but they keep working together. It's like these ants who make bridges in the water to survive. You know? That's what we have to do. That's where Varnashandana comes in. If we don't start working with the Varnashandana concept, we are babies. Prabhupada said 50% of my job is book distribution, and that will always remain the driving force. And then 50%, as we give our blood and sacrifice for book distribution, we have done in the past and we're still doing it. Now the next 50% is not done. That is this establishment of Varnashrama for the wider community. If you want to help devotees from outside, without this concept, they cannot make progress. They come to the temple 5 minutes, going in and out. This is not the real stuff. Vedic culture is much more than this, you know, going in and tingling them in, hide and go and do something. You know, it's a 24-hour job, absolute absorption. It's such a high culture. And Yudhishthira knew how to educate that. Not only he was a pure devotee, all the citizens there could easily become pure devotees because of the social system and the political system. It's all interconnected. You cannot separate. Finally, Achintya Veda Veda Tattva, you think you take the consequence of this. Simultaneously, one indifference. No, we are not involved in politics. But then sometimes, it's heavy politics. See, Maharaj Pariksit engaged in his political duties. What has a pure devotee to do with dirty politics? And which politics was more dirty than Hiranyakashipu's politics? You understand? But he has to take political duty. And why is that? So that the people would become the Lord's devotees. Yeah. So this 50% is not yet done, Prabhupada said. That is the Varnashrama. So how much blood and sweat and sacrifice we have done for book distribution, we can do for developing Varnashrama. And it makes sense. It makes so much sense. Why it is necessary. Otherwise we cannot survive. take some paper. It's all so much interconnected, these things. But how that works actually, so here in the purport, what a clear instruction is here. It is essential that society be divided into four groups of men. There should be Brahmanas identified, there should be Kshatriyas and administrators, good managers who can manage 500 people without dissatisfying them. Get the economics going, get the spiritual education going, get the Brahmacharis on the right spot, their servants. Just learning, be humble, that's all, that's Brahmacharya life, nothing else. Then get the Grihasthas rightly situated in a protective area that they not get influenced by negative vibrations. That's a Kshatriya, a protector, spiritually and materially. No pollution, no corruption, nothing. That's a Kshatriya. Who has that guts, who has that command, who can get everybody under him to follow like a menial servant. Not that everybody is equal, that God, that is modern, demonic thing. There's no question of equality. Never, ever. Even in the spiritual world, everybody bows down for Krishna. 100%. True is the devotees. There's always a hierarchy. And the demons exploit that perfectly in the opposite way. Even using God for this. To put themselves. That's a whole different topic which we have to understand. How we are sabotaged by the opposite pyramid of hierarchy. And externally using the democracy to make you a slave. Everybody's equal. Denmark is the best example of this. The wife cannot respect the husband. The students don't respect the teachers. We are all equal. Hi Jack, he's this teacher. Hi John, that's my father. Destroys absolutely everything. The principle of Vedicals is humble servant of the others. Otherwise nothing will work. So we are not scared to make these four divisions. A Brahmana, identifying a Brahmana, who is very pure and he is the most dynamic, that's another statement by Chen. He is the most dynamic in his heart to help others, more than the Kshatriya. Because the Kshatriya might a little bit be contaminated with some some worldly thing. Yeah? There's some passion there. But the Brahmana doesn't have that. So his flow of compassion is complete. His dynamics in the heart to always be there for others to help. Not that he sits in the corner and now and then he comes out. That is not Brahman. He is always thinking on the problems of the people. More than anyone else. And he has insight so scrutinizing. He sees the problem in every single detail. And he feels the problem. That problem is his own problem. That is Brahman. That is Vaishnava Brahman. That's the lab. And then he has to become a king. How is that? And then we have to apply it in our own centers, these principles. How far we are away from that? Giving so many reasons. Giving so many excuses. All of us. Because we, very culturally, we never experienced it. We never experienced it. In India, there are some glimpses. It's too long ago, 5,000 years, that's too long ago. But the power of the Hare Krishna movement is we can bring it back alive in its complete form, even in this horrible Kali Yuga. The question was asked by the sages to what is the best of age, what is the best gender, and what is the best varna, right? So the sages, they already know the answer. Satya Yuga, best gender is the male, and the best family is Brahma, right? But that was not asked by Vedavyas king. Vedavyas, the top authority, and they acknowledge. He says, the best age is coming now. Oh! The sage got completely disturbed, confused. Who? How our spiritual leader? He can talk like this. He has fallen down, I think. He's in Maya. No. Kali Yuga is the best, he said. And then he explained, the best gender is a woman's body. And the best dharma is Shudra. Oh, I don't want to be Shudra. What is the best? Dasa is worse than Shudra. We are simply servants of Krishna. In his plan, we serve others. Yeah, that's another statement for Varna. So why Kali Yuga is the best? Because simply in other ages you have to do much more sacrifice, dedication, meditation, so many pure principles, then you can elevate. But in this Kali Yuga, simply by doing the Harinam Sankirtan, you get all the results of the Vedas. And you become absolutely pure, simply by this Harinam. So only Sumedha-san, only those who have sharp intelligence, they understand this point of the power of the Harinam. Those who are not yet so intelligent, they get stuck up in mixed religious systems. They take other points more important. Something the Gyanakana is more important, something the Gyanakana is more important. That means Alpamedha-san, less intelligent. But those who are intelligent, they understand, my God, with the Harinam I get everything. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. And that is sufficient. I don't need anything else. Kali Yuga Devadatta, Mahaprabhu, there are so many bad qualities in this Kali Yuga. And we're going to clear them up. We're not going to neglect them, we're going to clean them. That is Vana Shandama's social system. We're going to clean all these things. That is the effect of Harinam. The effect of Harinam, if you really chant properly, you will be busy with all the other aspects. Achincha Veda Veda Tatra. This is one and different. It is not the same, at the same it is connected. We are also working on that. That the proof is Purana. Why he has to sit in a political business as a pure devotee? Why he has to do that? Interesting, huh? So by Harinam, then the best gender is a ladybody. Why? A man has to be so busy in the complicatedness of worldly life, so stuff. But a woman, if she simply serves her husband, she gets completely okay. Simply, whatever the husband might be, possibly, you know, not always perfect, right? Definitely Kali Yuga. But if the woman just don't see that and she just serves, not trying to find fault, just serve that, she becomes perfect. Much more easily. And then Sudra, because also, he by simply serving, become perfect. And so like this. So then the Vaishyas also should be there. What is a Vaishya main thing? Krishi, Gorakshaya, Vanyam. So the first thing is Krishi, agriculture. So in our movement we need a lot of devotees who are expert in agriculture. And that has to be boosted, that there has to be courses on it, that has to be teach to other Grihasthas. Those who know agriculture, they should teach it. And then cow protection, Krishi Gorakshaya, that's the first thing for the economic class, mercantile. Then, a little trade, if there is excess, not to make profit. Just I have too many things, so I cannot throw it out. That's the idea of trade. Not the export-import concept, you know, to squeeze out one country. The British Empire could only grow potatoes on their land. You know that? England is the most unfertile land. So they understood that we're going to die here if we don't make some tricks here. So they sucked out all India. Because because it's so rich on itself. So that's why they start import-export with some smart ideas, and it was just a sucking business. This is not Vaishya. And still the economic is based on this today. Whatever we buy blood on our fingers. You know that? And we don't want to challenge the system. We don't want to create an alternative system, even on a small scale. If you think in Denmark, how many devotees in 30 years has given their blood to the Hare Krishna movement? And we cannot gather them together under a concept that is absolutely impossible. And then those who they are here from all parts of the world who know the Hare Krishna consciousness, and bring them together, and put them in working concepts based on the development of the Anasham community development. How much energy will come from that? How many 100 times more good distribution will do? 100%. Because the people, they live from these books. These books are good. These people doing something because of these books. It's interaction. And we have so much congregation, we have so many, all the devotees who are very wise, who have learned the scripture in and out, and active, each learner can be active, isn't it? And part, a very big part of that is exposing that. And then, also, this Vaishya thing, this economic principle is so extremely dominating today. So let's put real economics there. Krishi production, localized agriculture. We get some land somewhere nearby Copenhagen and we start something because we are convinced we have to do it. In Vrindavan now, there was 5 days conference on Dharmasangha development. Sridharam Swami in August, he gave a presentation to North American GBC who 1 year ago wanted to neglect this subject. And suddenly it changed by Krishna Jain, and he made a presentation. He's a big pillar in leadership in this country, and he said the absolute need for establishment of Anasham. His lectures on Dandarats, it's wonderful. We should discuss it immediately here in the Yatra. How to use his points in our Yatra. That is taking advice of leadership. That is Brahma, he takes advice. He gives advice, he takes advice from the right sources. Immediately he acts on that. And then also in Vrindavan, these discussions are going on. The next ILS meetings and GBC meetings, it becomes a very important topic. It's growing. There was some resistance last year, but now we see we have to do it. And one of the reasons is because the system is drying up. Now we start on the alternative. Now. And part of that, it's a big thing because if we neglect such an important instruction of the spiritual master, Prabhupada says, if we neglect the instruction of the spiritual master, we become useless. That means I become useless, then the devotees become useless, the whole movement get disconnected from Prabhupada. Same thing when we neglect book distribution, there is no connection. That's on that instruction I joined a temple, I gave up my business for all these things because in Belgium there's no book distribution. I said, I hear that class. There's no book distribution. We are sitting in limbo. There's no connection with Prabhupada. If I don't tell you, I'm not doing my duty as spiritual master. Then I disconnect from Prabhupada. And if I am disconnected from Prabhupada, you are disconnected from Prabhupada. And then we are all sitting in blah blah. Right?